Radioactivity can be quite scary, but among geologists and prospectors alike, its existence can be economically important and a potential signal of fortunes to come, much like discovering gold nuggets. For example, did you know that one of the largest rare earth element deposits in all of North America, the Mountain Pass mine in California, was discovered due in part to some weird-looking minerals that were abnormally radioactive? Well, many of the scientists among my audience are familiar with the fact that three particular elements with four isotopes are responsible for most background low levels of radioactivity all rock samples contain, you might be surprised to learn that none of these are the most common radioactive isotope naturally found in the ground. This is why I have decided to create today's video to discuss the 10 most common naturally occurring rather than human-created radioactive isotopes in the Earth's crust. Of course, am I making this video also partially as an excuse to show you some radioactive minerals I own? Absolutely. Let's begin starting from the most common. The most common technically radioactive isotope comprising 84.15 parts per million of the entire Earth's crust is calcium-48. But wait, before you runly spit out any milk you might be currently drinking, since that is a good source of calcium, know this. The half-life of calcium-48 is 56 quintillion years, which, if written out, looks like this, 56 followed by 18 zeros. That happens to be more than 4 billion times longer than the age of the universe. In other words, calcium-48 has such an absurdly low level of radioactivity that it isn't problematic or even a health hazard, so drinking milk has zero radiation dangers from this isotope. To prevent more confusion on obscurely long-lived isotopes, the rest of this video will be split into technically radioactive and easily measurably radioactive segments, the latter of which I will define as an isotope having a half-life of 1 trillion years or less. Here's a quick chart of the 10 most common technically radioactive isotopes in the Earth's crust, which includes an isotope of calcium, rubidium, thorium, zirconium, potassium, uranium, samarium, europium, and two isotopes of neodymium. And now, here is that same chart, but for easily measurable radioactive isotopes. Surprisingly, an isotope of an element few people have ever heard of, rubidium, specifically rubidium-87, is the most common, easily measurable radioactive isotope in the Earth's crust. With a concentration of 30.58 parts per million, rubidium-87 is more than twice as common as all of the world's naturally occurring crustal uranium and thorium isotopes combined. Since rubidium is a trace component in some but not all lepidolite deposits, it is one reason why some pegmatites are slightly radioactive. However, its half-life is more than three times as long as the age of the universe. Moving on, the second most common radioactive isotope is the main isotope of the element thorium in the crust, thorium-232. It outranks uranium isotopes because as a whole, thorium is both lower on the periodic table and is more common than uranium in the Earth's crust. However, another thorium isotope, thorium-230, is the ninth most common, and despite its short half-life of 75,400 years, it remains at higher than expected concentrations since it represents a natural step on uranium-238's decay chain. Speaking of uranium, its two most common isotopes come in as 4th and 9th, being U-238 and U-235 respectively. In 3rd place, we have the isotope potassium-40, which occurs at a concentration of 2.52 parts per million in the crust. This isotope comprises a negligible 0.012% of all potassium which exists, making it fairly common since potassium by weight is the crust's 5th most common element. This is why if you put a banana in front of a very sensitive and specialized Geiger counter, you will be able to eventually just barely make out the teeny tiny amount of this radioactive isotope present within it. This is such a low level that you would have to eat 100,000 bananas a year to receive enough radiation to have a very slight increased risk of getting cancer. So, just like milk, consuming bananas is not a health concern for radiation. In spots 5, 6, and 7, we have three isotopes of three different rare earth elements, meaning they only rarely occur in concentrations high enough to be detectable. Lastly, in 10th, we have rhenium-187, which is the most common isotope of Earth's fifth rarest element that also has at least one stable isotope.